the clients first approached me to look at the house that they just purchased, which was really in a derelict state, a early Georgian semi-detached villa. They were very open-minded and wanted the project to be really extraordinary, and were just very open to what we could put forward for them. So a combination of a little bit the non-orthogonal site and the existing bay window at the back of the house, because there was a very big ungainly bay window on the back elevation, were kind of triggers for the geometry, the overall geometry of our extension. The planners were actually quite open-minded. They really appreciated the approach that to kind of preserve and enhance the qualities of an existing conservation area, or the kind of neoclassical compositional rules of an early Georgian house, that if you produce something new that contrasts that, it can be more effective and in a way more respectful of the existing architecture. So the whole approach to the house was to kind of tie the spaces of the Georgian architecture together with the converted, extended, open spaces, and to tie the whole thing very closely with the garden. And so it acts as a kind of device for intensifying the relationship with the walnut tree, the sunlight from the south, and the whole house in a way becomes more permeable. Really, the material choice comes from the geometry that, and the kind of architectural approach in general. This idea of plasticity, that the envelope or the form and the space that's contained within the form are very are kind of pure in a way. The envelope reflects exactly the space of the volumes within. So working with a sheet material was crucial to the project, and we initially designed it to be clad in zinc. Interestingly enough, the client suggested using Corian because he'd seen it used in some European project. And it's virtually the exact same detail as we'd designed the building with. It's a rain screen, it's a panel, and you place it on rails, cladding rails. And it's such a great material because it's dimensionally stable, it's completely even in its color, and kind of easy to cut and place on site. And we achieved some really quite amazing details in terms of just the geometry of 7 or 8 planes coming together in one point and coming together sort of perfectly without any flashing and without any sort of extraneous bits. I think I probably started out with a kind of conventional modernist approach that maximize the glass and the outside comes in, and it's, you know, that's the kind of best solution. But I've kind of come to the conclusion, or the sense in the last few years, that it's much more important to be very specific about particular things that you want to perceive or appreciate. You have a framed view in a particular direction, and then you sort of look down over the kitchen, and you also sort of look through the Georgian windows to the street, and it's a completely different way of kind of perceiving that boundary between the inside and the outside. And then the extension in a way has a traditional glass shop front, so from the street it kind of reads like a shop front, but it sort of transforms as the kind of geometry and the enclosure wraps around the building. They work in the side extension, and so they have their business there, they have people coming and going, and they get to sort of, they say it feels like they're working in the garden, and it, you know, they couldn't imagine a better place to work. They're really, really happy with the way the house works, the kind of very open kitchen and living sort of minstrel's gallery. It's great for parties, and they're thrilled with it.